IIT Kanpur is one of the few institutions in the world which considers its student opinion so important and trusts its students so much that the views of its student representatives are considered even in issues like terminations, academic structure, course credits, time-tabling decisions, and a lot of such important decisions.
It is very difficult for faculty to even understand the student point of view. In such cases, DOGC plays a key role in conveying a student view. Such recent event was the issue on minor registration deadline, when it was actually scheduled before academic registration and the students were not even informed about this. The faculty has a point that they have put the thing on website, but it was very ambiguous as students were not informed with any notice. The issue was put on table by a student representative, and after long fighting discussion, the view of the students were considered and deadline was appropriately postponed.
Okay, so there are two main parts of the job. One is conveying information from the DOGC to the students. So a lot of important issues are discussed in the DOGC and they need to be conveyed to the students. So that is one part of the job. The other aspect is conveying information from the students to the DOGC. So each issue generates a varied kind of view in students, and that needs to be conveyed to the DOGC so that the DOGC gets to know what the students think and can take a constructive view forward. So these views can be personal in case of a personal decision, or it can be a survey of students on an issue that affects the entire department.
Last year regarding this, there was an interesting incident actually. So the fourth year UG students were having a timetable clash with a core course along with the departmental electives and the open electives. So at that time, I being the DUGC student representative, talked with my batchmates who were 4th year-ites, actually 82 of them in a classroom, and found out probable time slots in the whole week for the specific course.
Okay, so during registrations or branch change, or if you want to convert to a dual degree, you are often told jao DOGC se sign karwa lo. So what is this DOGC? Is the person the DOGC?
No, this person is the convener of the DOGC, whom you see actually. The DOGC is actually their departmental unaccredited committee that consists of minimum 4 to maximum 8 professors from various streams, and along with 2 students. These 10 people completely decide your academic curriculum and other aspects. And also, this is important that this is a platform where the students have an equal say as a professor. So it's the same platform for both of them. Hence, your views count for this post.
You are on the same footing as a professor, so it is important.
Our academic structure is getting vast and vibrant day by day, with new features adding in like minor programs, double majors, course restructuring, interdepartmental courses. All these new things are in budding stage, and still everything has a large potential to change in more vibrant and better system. So that UGC representative can be the convener of the newest path, can strengthen the roots of these newly laid policies. So if you wish for some change in your academics of your department, it is time for you. It is an opportunity for you. Come up and grab it.
Very often, for various academic decisions in SCGC and Academic Senate, the departments are requested to give their opinions and feedback on the issue. For example, this recently happened in the case of minors, double majors, and similar changes in the academic structure. In such discussions in DOGC, the opinion of the student representative is given as much weightage as is the opinion of any faculty member of the committee. This, I believe, is a huge responsibility, because you have the power to change any decision which affects the students of your department or of the whole institute for a long span of time.
Now about the commitment. The commitment is not a hour per week commitment. The commitment is about sincerity, and you have to be serious throughout the time, especially during the time of the beginning of the semesters when the registration is going on, and at the end of the semesters, actually between the semester breaks, when the termination cases and etc. come into the DOGC, you have to be serious at that time and be in the campus and attend those meetings and act as a student representative in those days. Also, specifically now, while allotting minors and other data the student representative can go and help the DUGC convener in all these activities throughout the day. The departmental UG committee is responsible for the complete academic requirements and conditions of the student. So in this matter, suppose a new course is being proposed or there had been an old course where new contents have to be added, all of these things comes into the DUGC for discussion, where the student representative becomes an important part in providing the feedback of the students. It might be the past students, the current students, or it might be an individual feedback, as said by Pratyush earlier. And specifically for the tutorial classes and the course structure, Pratyush will be giving you a very important example.
As Shandeep mentioned, I will give you an instance that I encountered during my tenure. So what happened was that SUGC had proposed a change whereby the current system of tutorials was going to change, and we would have one smaller IPSA for a small section of students and another called DEPA where the large number of students would be there and tougher problems would be discussed. Now this matter came up to the DUGC of E department. But the E department already had a very good system of tutorials whereby we had quizzes every week and a small class section, sort of IPSA but with tougher problems discussed. So I discussed with it with the few students, past students, current students, and all of them were of the view that this is a very good system and shouldn't be changed because it promotes continuous evaluation throughout the semester, and students actually learn through this rather than giving an exam at the end of this of the year. So E department was one of the few departments that did not accept this proposal, and we still have the quiz type single tutorial every week.
At times during my tenure as a DUGC student representative, I have felt that I had to take certain decisions at certain moments which ultimately proved good for the student, but during that time it might have looked very different. So the story goes on something like this, that there was a student who got terminated in one semester, he was reinstated back, but in that ongoing semester he was suffering through a family problem and also a health problem. So when he came to me for help, I suggested that he take a semester leave at that time and then re-register in the next semester. The student at that time was in such a mental state that he felt that this might derail his whole curriculum to a different way, and also his program might get extended. He did it, he didn't go to termination once more, and he came back and he is now doing courses. But had he not taken this decision, the situation might have been different.
As a DUGC nominee, you can be the voice of your fellow students. Any matter like timetable clash, course restructuring, you can raise it. So come, make the things happen, convey the change.
Well, this is an election where there will be no fulfillment of promises.
This is an election where the person's voice is your opinion and will affect you as well as the next generation academically.
Have you ever felt that your voice has not been heard in your department? Have you ever wanted to change something about your department?
If yes, then this is your chance to continue. This is your chance to bring that change that you always wanted to see in the academics.